It's a fucking sneeze. Since when did it become so deadly to you?
With all these black marks that go off, I guess.
Totoro, the other day you literally coughed and your coat caught on fire. Deku, you literally got scared and broke a chair.
Ruby, you literally sleep flow.
And Vivian, it was cold one day and you shivered as much as your engine stressed. Oh, and you went for an 8K accidental run. Froppy, you literally got scared when the toast dropped out of the toaster and you jumped onto the roof. Dark Shadow, you literally coughed in your sleep and Dark Shadow nearly ate the entire dorms.
Oh, look at 1A arguing. 1B doesn't do that, yet 1A is meant to be better than 1B.
Monomo, you were laughing so hard with Tetsu that you clapped his heart while slapping him on the back that you gave him.
Oh, scary! Oh, shiver my timbers! Shut up, man!
So I see y'all just letting anybody
see,
in here.
Was gonna...
Hey! Don't y'all start that in here. Y'all better not.
Sorry, God.
I'm sorry, God.
Respect trans rights, or I swear to God, I will come to your house and choke you with a jolly
stars to crumble to the sound of the drums. Oh boy, there ain't no need to buy that diamond ring. It ain't no big thing. Just show her a little.
Lay down my hands, press to your cheeks. A long way from the playground. I have loved you since we were 18.
Welcome to Jurassic Park.
I don't give a fuck what you have to say about doctors working in this pandemic right now. Great, now that I have your attention, let's clarify what I mean by that so that y'all don't berate me. It seems that anytime anyone tries to advocate for blue-collar workers right now, the privileged-ass, upper-middle-class people who probably never worked a fast-food job in their life try to counter-argue with, well, how do you think the doctors and nurses feel right now? They have it so much harder than you. Okay, no one said being a doctor's easy. And in all honesty, none of us are really saying that, like, bagging groceries is hard. What we are saying is that it's clearly a very vital job to your everyday life. And I think for that, we deserve livable wages and respect. And that's why we don't bring doctors into the argument. You've always respected doctors. But sadly, it took a global pandemic and national emergency for a lot of you to realize that you should respect the person taking your order or stocking the shelves. Of course we're all thankful for doctors, and of course they're a high risk, but don't use that to diminish the struggles of the average citizen.
To anyone that's watching this and takes the time to actually finish this video, thank you. This is my suicide letter. To anyone that's feeling the same way, who has thought of this as a way to solve their problems, no. It is running away from your problems. It is giving a reason for the people that you love to go and find a casket that's gonna fit you to bury you in. It is having someone find you in that state that is never going to leave their memory. It is having your best friends having to post a yearly death anniversary picture for you on Instagram. Don't do it because you think it will never get better. Because if you kill yourself, you would never know.
Don't do it because someone told you to. Because someone went out of their way to say that you are not enough. Because if you kill yourself, then they win. Suicide is a permanent solution for a temporary problem. You can do it. You can get through this. Don't let killing yourself ever be an option. Please, your life is worth living.